Hello, this is CoolTechZone Consulting. How can I help you? Slow Wi-Fi speed. Yeah, all right, listen. Have you tried turning it off and on again?
Okay, this is not going to be that piece of advice. We're going to take this seriously. I've made a list of the 7 things you can try to increase your internet speeds. So first, you need to know what you're dealing with. How do you test Wi-Fi speed? Well, multiple websites can do an internet speed test. I usually use speedtest.net since they have a very nicely detailed Wi-Fi speed test tool. And if the numbers don't say much to you, you can use this graph thingy to check if your speeds are fast enough. The goal is to get over the 100 megabits per second mark, ideally around 200 to 300 megabits per second, especially if you have multiple devices. So what can you do to get there? Start by ensuring you have a good Wi-Fi signal. Most devices have a little Wi-Fi connection strength icon, and in the best case scenario, all the bars should be full. If it's not, check if your Wi-Fi signal isn't obstructed by walls, furniture, or any other physical barrier. Radio waves from other devices can cause some issues as well, so don't place your router near a Bluetooth speaker or near the microwave. A splash of reheated spaghetti sauce isn't going to help you either. The ideal position is away from obstructions, maybe on a higher shelf somewhere in the center of your home. If your router has antennas, you can also try adjusting them. These antennas send the Wi-Fi signal in all directions, perpendicularly. If you have your router on the second floor and the Wi-Fi speed on the first floor sucks, you can adjust one of your router antenna positions to be horizontal. But if you need a stronger signal on the same floor, position router antennas to all stand vertically. Also, did you know you should replace your router every few years? If it's working smoothly, obviously drain it until it breaks. But an old router might be the root of your Wi-Fi speed problems. Even the most expensive routers from 2016 can give you a much worse performance than a cheaper one today. But don't cheap out on this stuff if you want it to last long and work well. Just like your router can ruin your Wi-Fi speeds, your internet service provider, ISP in short, might also be the problem. Especially if everything worked great for a while and then you suddenly started having Wi-Fi problems. In this case, you might be dealing with ISP throttling. What is ISP throttling? It occurs when your ISP intentionally reduces your internet speed. If you're suspecting that's the reason for your slow Wi-Fi, the solution is getting a VPN. It will encrypt your traffic and prevent your ISP from seeing what websites you visit. Yes, they can track that, and then limit your speeds to discourage you from using certain websites while prioritizing others. As for VPN recommendations, any reputable VPN should do this job well. The only thing you need to do is connect to a server and keep that connection active as you browse. But you might want to look for a provider with good performance, since otherwise a VPN can slow your Wi-Fi down even further. The current fastest option is NordVPN by far, due to their proprietary NordLynx protocol, which allows minimal speed reduction. But if you want something a little bit cheaper, Surfshark works great as well. I'll leave a link to these two in the description, check them out. They often have big discount deals running, so you can save some money. How to make your internet fast another way is by switching your Wi-Fi frequency band. Modern routers work primarily on 2 radio frequency bands, 2.4 and 5 gigahertz. The first most commonly used, but it trades speed for range, while the 5 gigahertz band is better for speeds, but covers a shorter distance. If you want to change it, you're first going to need to identify your router's IP address. Usually it's one of these two, but I'll leave directions in the description on how to find it manually. Then type in the IP address in your browser, and in that page that pops up, enter the router's username and password. It's usually written on the back of the router. There, find the wireless settings, which usually hide under the advanced section, and there, change the frequency band. Save your changes, and then you should see a Wi-Fi network pop up in the Wi-Fi list, usually with a corresponding frequency label in the name. Moving on, if you're wondering, why is my Wi-Fi so slow, only in specific rooms, you're dealing with a dead zone. In this case, either try trick number 2 or extend your Wi-Fi network's range with additional tools. There are Wi-Fi boosters, wired access points, power line extenders, or mesh Wi-Fi systems. The latter is better for full house coverage if your home's particularly large. If you're dealing with just one stubborn dead zone, then a Wi-Fi booster is the way to go. The last tip I have for how to get fast internet speed is to not use Wi-Fi at all. Yeah, I know, super helpful. But if you're dealing with high bandwidth activities like gaming and you can get get an Ethernet cable to your location, use it. It's less convenient, I know, but much faster and much more stable. So tell me, how fast is your internet now? Did any of these tips help? Or maybe you have more tips of your own? Share them in the comments. I'll meet you there. Oh, and don't forget to subscribe while you're at it. I heard that supporting small YouTube channels gives you karma points, which boosts your Wi-Fi speeds.